The next presentation is from Justin Tremain, Managing Director of Future Metals NL, with the ticker code FME. Today, Justin will be providing an overview of the Panton PGM project in Western Australia, which is one of Australia's largest and highest grade PGM projects. Justin, how are you?
Good, thanks, Jane, and thanks for the time today and the opportunity to present Future and our Panton project here in WA. So Future Metals is a relatively new company, having relisted on the ASX 2 or 3 months ago, which was following the recompliance listing following the acquisition of 100% ownership of this Panton project here in Western Australia and an associated capital raising. So the Panton project is a platinum palladium project in northern Western Australia, and it's in fact the highest grade PGM project in Australia and probably the highest undeveloped PGM project in the world. So very significant, with an established JORC compliant resource of over 2 million ounces. So as I said, we have 100% ownership of this project with no encumbrances attached to that in terms of debt or anything like that. There's a JORC resource established of 2.4 million ounces at a grade of 5 grams, which I'll touch on in a moment and run you through that. That resource is completely open at outcrop, so it's from surface, but it's open in all directions, open down dip and along strike. And we've got a 10,000 meter drilling program that we commenced almost immediately upon listing on the ASX. And we're about 3,000 meters into that program at the moment, with a significant number of assays in the lab, and look to start reporting results in the coming weeks. There's been some recent metallurgical test work undertaken on this deposit, and there was in fact a breakthrough on the metallurgy that was based on some test work undertaken by the previous owner, Panoramic Resources, in 2015, where they were able to achieve a very high grade PGM concentrate with excellent recoveries through conventional crushing and grinding. The project's located on granted mining leases, which will give us a great time benefit as we move this project forward into development. As I show you on the next slide, the company and I think the merits of the project has attracted a very high caliber board and management team to the company. I joined the company as part of the acquisition of this project and the recompliance onto the ASX, and have significant experience in managing junior companies through discovery, delineation of resources, feasibility, and ultimately corporate outcomes that create significant shareholder value for shareholders. Also joining me on the board was Alan Mulligan. He's a mining engineer, South African mining engineer. Previously spent about 15 years with one of the world's biggest PGM producers, Lonmin, in South Africa, and developed and managed several PGM mines in South Africa, a very similar style to the Panton project. Also of note was Mick McMullen, has joined as an advisor to the company and shareholder in the company. Most relevantly, Mick ran a company called Stillwater Mining Company, which is one of the biggest PGM producers outside of South Africa, and ran that company through to its takeover by Sibanye, one of the world's biggest PGM producers, which created a lot of value for shareholders. And he obviously has a very strong understanding of the PGM market, and actually has a very strong understanding of this project, given Stillwater was very keen to buy this project, and hence his involvement in Future Metals when we were able to acquire this project. And just flick through to the next slide. Thanks. So just quickly, just a corporate overview. So the company's very modest market capitalization, have only listed about 2 or 3 months ago on the ASX. The market capitalization of only just over $60 million. Well funded, with just over $8 million in the bank, and that's as at today. So just on the location of the project, it's an ideally located project. You couldn't get a better location for the development of a project. Firstly, it's in Western Australia, which is quite unique for a PGM mine and project. 85% of the world's PGM production currently comes out of South Africa and Russia. So to have a high-grade tier one PGM project in a jurisdiction as Western Australia is very unique, and I think it's very strategic corporately for the company going forward. It's well located at just over 1 kilometer off a sealed highway, the Great Northern Highway, which runs up to the Port of Wyndham, where currently Panoramic export their nickel concentrates from. It's had a previous, this project, the resource was established back in 2003, about 20 years ago, and there's been no drilling since then. The drilling that we're doing is the first drilling in 20 years. But back in 2003, there was a bankable feasibility study done, hence it's on granted mining leases. And most importantly, there was a lot of environmental work done as part of that BFS, which demonstrated that there was no fatal flaws to developing this project. There was even a exploration decline put in to access the top of the ore body, provide metallurgical test work. So there's been a lot of work done on this project over the last 20-25 years. If I just flick through to the next slide on the geology. So the mineralization is, the high grade mineralization is associated with chromatite reefs, which outcrop the surface, as I mentioned, and on this slide here, you can see that's been domained into four zones, the A, B, C, and D zone. And these wrap around a layered intrusion that's structured as a syncline structure. So essentially the hull of a boat or a keel of a boat. They're quite steeply dipping at surface, but as they come underneath the underside of that syncline, these zones are expected to join together, but that hasn't been drill tested yet, and that's something that we'll be looking to do, and potentially that's where we can get some bonanza grades and widths. But at the moment, the resource is contained within only those A, B, C, and D zones, which extends through about 3.5 kilometres of strike, but there's been 12 kilometres of outcropping chromatite reef mapped at surface. So only about 30% of that outcropping chromatite reef is currently contained within that resource, which is already very significant at over 2 million ounces. Just on the resource, as you'll note here on the resource table, it's a very robust resource with about 90% of the tonnes sitting in the measured and indicated category. So there's been a lot of drilling, about 50,000 metres of drilling has gone into this, been a lot of money spent on the project, albeit that was done 20 years ago and there's been no drilling over the last 20 years. But the resource is very robust, so there's not a lot more infill drilling that we need to do to take this through to a new feasibility study and ultimately development. The drilling that we're doing is looking at expanding the resource, and we see significant scope to do that, as I'll show you. The resource is contained within two chromatite reefs, the top reef and the middle reef. And it's important to note the top reef contains about 80% of the ounces, or about 2 million ounces, at even higher grade of about 6 grams per tonne. One of the opportunities with this project that really is now starting to emerge, and hopefully we'll demonstrate that with drilling results in the coming months, is this resource was really only constrained to the chrome reefs that have been mapped at surface and then drilled. And the mineralisation is contained within those chrome reefs. However, outside of those chrome reefs, there would be about 10 to 30 metres generally of lower grade mineralisation that hasn't been contained in this resource. And so that's potentially another 5 to 10 times the widths of mineralisation that we could look to model, albeit at lower grade, but at surface. And that's something that we'll be looking to do, and we're looking to prove that potential with drilling that we're undertaking at the moment. On the metallurgy, so when a feasibility study was done on this project back in 2003, it involved quite an intensive processing route on site, which came with a lot of capital and operating costs. Subsequent to that, Panoramic Resources acquired this project back in 2011, and they acquired the project to look at developing it and putting the ore through their Savannah nickel flotation plant, which is about 30 kilometres up the road to the north. And so they undertook, whilst no drilling, they undertook a lot of metallurgical test work, and in 2015 had a significant breakthrough with this, and were able to demonstrate through conventional crushing, grinding, and flotation, nothing special about it at all, are able to achieve a very high grade concentrate rate of over 200 grams per tonne. Anything over 100 grams per tonne, you know, is very attractive to offtake parties. So to achieve 270 grams per tonne PGM concentrate with a very low mass pull of about 2.5% and recoveries of over 80% was a significant breakthrough for this project. And that's where we're looking to take this project. We're doing confirmatory and optimization metallurgical work at the moment to confirm these results, and then looking at ultimately developing this project just through conventional crushing, grinding, and flotation, and no further technical risk or capital risk associated beyond that. So just, I touched on the exploration potential. I think this slide here sums it up here. So the current resource, you can see the outcropping chromatite reef as it's been mapped at surface. The current resource sits within those red zones there, and all the yellow areas is outcropping, known mineralised PGM mineralisation at surface that is yet to be drilled and is therefore not included in this resource. And you can see just to the right there, the geochemistry, so that's soil sampling, and we're showing platinum and palladium grades there. And you can see outside of the ABCD zones, there's several targets of known chromatite reef with anomalous geochemistry still to be drilled. So a lot of scope to expand what is already the highest grade deposit in Australia and already is a significant resource at over 10 million ounces. And then also at depth, so there's a high grade plunge component to this. The A and B zone in particular, as you can see here in these hotter colours, is plunging down to the southwest. And that hasn't been followed up with drilling. And you can see some very high grade results there, 8 metres at 4 grams PGM, 6 metres at over 7 grams PGM. And then there's no further drilling down to plunge on that. So our current 10,000 metre drilling program is not only looking to expand the resource in the top 150 metres, but also to chase some of this high grade at depth where it wraps underneath this incline and potentially have some bonanza grades at depth. So just in summary, I don't have too long to run through it. It is a very significant tier one PGM project. We have 100% ownership of that. Established resource, so it's a very advanced project at over 2 million ounces at 5 grams per ton, but with scope to grow that resource, I think, significantly. And our current drill program, which is a minimum of 10,000 metres, which will run all the way through till Christmas, and then no doubt will be extended beyond that. We're already 3,000 metres into that with a lot of samples in the lab that we'll start to report in the coming weeks. And a very strategic located PGM project, given it is outside of South Africa and Russia and in a tier one jurisdiction such as Western Australia. And it's just the next slide quickly, Jane, just to put it in perspective. Here is a slide of all the undeveloped PGM projects around the world, both ASX listed and TSX listed companies. You can see Future Metals Panton project, 100% owned, and just as a standout in terms of grade, that green circle up the top there, there's nothing that comes near it in terms of grade. So that just puts the project in perspective. So I think that's all I've got time for today. Thank you very much and happy to take any questions.
Justin, great presentation. You actually just answered one of the questions that just popped through. So just on the drilling program, you did mention it's 10,000 metres and you're already 3,000 metres into that. So I'll jump into some others. So at what depth does the boat hull shape mineralisation bottom out? And is there any other nickel copper components associated with the mineralisation?
Sure. Yeah. So the ABC zones have been drilled down to about 600 metres depth. The D zone's only been drilled down to about 400 metres of depth. And this is where they're all, the dip is flattening out, and that's where expected the A, B and T zone will come together around that sort of 600 to 800 metres depth. And at those depth, at these grades, you know, that's very economic still at those depths, given it's over 5 grams per tonne. But really our focus at the moment, so we've drilled some deeper holes to test for that deeper mineralisation. And right now we're drilling shallower holes sort of in the top 150 metres, looking at expanding and bulking out the resource that would become ultimately open pittable resource in that top 150 metres. There is potential for other mineralisation such as nickel, and the nickel grades do tend to increase at depth. It's already quite significant. There's actually 30,000 tonnes of nickel contained in this resource, so it's not to be overlooked.
Interesting. And so just with all the drilling that you are doing, what are the assay, what are the labs like? When can shareholders expect assay results coming through?
Yeah, it's all diamond drilling that we're doing, because a lot of the drilling we're doing was for metallurgical samples and needs to be diamond core, and some of the deeper holes obviously require diamond drilling. But as I said, we've done about 3,000 metres of drilling at the moment, and majority of that is actually in the labs and been there for a couple of weeks, and we'd hope to start reporting results hopefully in the next 2 or 3 weeks, and then it'll be quite a regular news flow as samples are going off weekly into the laboratory.
Wonderful. It looks like you've got a fair bit of news flow coming up and a good time to be investing. So thank you for joining us today, Justin. I appreciate your time.
Thanks for your time.